Should all children get vaccinated against COVID-19? Vaccinating children against COVID-19 is very important to completely stop the pandemic from claiming more lives. But there's a question that needs an answer. Should every child be vaccinated? The general answer is yes, however, it can turn into depends based on ongoing situations in the region. For this pandemic, one variable that can change the answer from yes to depends is the number of vaccinated people in a country. On May 14, BBC reported that the World Health Organization urged rich countries to delay vaccination to children. The organization asked them to share doses with COVAX so poorer regions can get more. This is like balancing the total percentage of vaccinated people across all territories. The request is associated with the massive doses obtained by rich nations since December, when the first EUA-granted vaccine came out. Until today, most doses are available in high-income nations while COVAX struggles in distributing limited doses in low-income nations, which could not afford to make the best deals with vaccine makers. In low and lower middle-income countries, COVID-19 vaccine supply has not been enough to even immunize healthcare workers, said Tedros Adhanom Ghebreyesus, WHO Director General. Healthcare workers should be the first recipient of COVID-19 vaccines regardless of territory. There are still several countries that have not completed two-dose regimens in every single healthcare worker. But just when things are going smoothly to many rich nations, a vaccine brand received EUA for teens. Thus, some nations are now giving their extra doses to adolescents, which is not an illegal step to combat the crisis. If the answer is yes, the follow-up explanation is children take a chunk of the world's population. Even with several COVID vaccine brands in distribution, not a single dose can be given to a child without conditional approval for months until recently. Children are entitled to receive medical attention and their participation may help stop community transmission. According to a study in The Lancet, fewer than 2 of every million children died from COVID since the pandemic began. The majority of children who were infected by SARS-CoV-2 usually develop mild symptoms, if not without. If governments would choose between yes or no, children with very high exposure risk, serious outcomes, and severe disabilities in residential care obviously require the doses. Vaccinating children is not new and has been done to combat other diseases like polio, measles, and mumps. We'll be right back.